big round of applause for the session. As on occasion of International Women's Day, all women presented the presentation. Thank you, everyone. Since we are short of time, so I'll just proceed ahead to our next panel discussion. That is on vaccination by Immunization Technical Support Unit. I request Dr. Preetu Dalaria, Director at ITSU New Delhi, to kindly come over the stage to moderate this panel discussion. Before that, I request Dr. Purva to kindly come and give a brief introduction to the vaccination immunization.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. I am Apurva Rastogi, Project Officer, Immunization Technical Support Unit. We are now organizing two sessions back-to-back, a panel discussion, one on role of medical colleges in reaching 90% full immunization coverage. The other session will be on addressing vaccine hesitancy in India. I would now like to request the panelists to please come on the stage for the first session, which is on role of medical colleges in reaching 90% full immunization coverage. Dr. Sunila Garg, Director Professor, Maulana Azad Medical College. Dr. Sunila Garg is a trained medical doctor with specialization in community medicine. Her professional career spans over 37 years in multiple fields of public health, including RCH, HIV/AIDS, adolescent health, gender issues, NCDs, vector-borne diseases. She is currently serving as Director Professor and Head Community Medicine of Maulana Azad Medical College and Associated Hospitals. Professor Partha Nandi, Vice Principal, Mahatma Gandhi Medical College and Research Institute, Pondicherry. He is a medical doctor and is currently serving as a Vice Principal at Mahatma Gandhi Medical College and Research Institute, Pondicherry. He is also serving as Professor of Community Medicine at the same college and holds around 11 years of teaching experience. Next, I would like to invite Dr. Mangala Sood, State Immunization Officer to Government of Himachal Pradesh. She is a trained physician and is currently working as Faculty of Pediatrics at IGMC Shimla and State Immunization Officer to Government of Himachal Pradesh since 2013. She has around 15 years of working experience as a medical doctor with around 5 years in experience in pediatrics. She has a specialized interest in asthma, TB, and pediatric rheumatology. Next panelist is Dr. G.K. Soni, Program Leader, Urban Immunization, ITSU. Dr. G.K. Soni has over 18 years of work experience in public health with major focus on immunization. He has supervisory and managerial experience for about 16 years in carrying out polio eradication activities in high priority states of India, especially Bihar, UP, and Rajasthan. Dr. Preetu Dalaria, who will be moderating this session, Dr. Preetu Dalaria is director of ITSU. He is a physician specialized in public health. His professional career spans over past 20 years in multiple fields of public health, including immunization, vaccine access and delivery, vaccine introduction, communicable diseases, strategic medical and health communications, and healthcare technologies. He has worked across all levels and settings of the public health system. Over past 20 years, he has worked with organizations such as DFID, WHO, PATH, and BMGF. I would now request him to please moderate the session further. Thank you.
Good evening, respected panelists, my seniors, colleagues, and friends. So today we are going to discuss about the role of medical colleges in reaching 90% full immunization coverage, how the medical college can support. So before I start the discussion, I just want to let you know that when we are talking about the immunization in public sector in India, we need to understand that we are talking about almost 27 million birth cohort, which is much more than total population of many countries. Annually, we are targeting almost 30 million pregnant females. More than 9 million sessions are planned. And we have like more than 27,000 cold chain points for the vaccine distribution. It's a huge program. And And it's a very important program, one of the biggest public health program in the world. Recently, it has got focus when our Prime Minister started monitoring this program himself under the Pragati. He himself started monitoring and given us the target that we should reach 90% fully immunization coverage by 2018. Earlier, the target was 2020, but it was preponed by him. Looking at that, there were a lot of initiative from the government to reach this target. We started a Mission in the Unreach program. It was a mission program to reach the unreach. And then we launched the intensified mission in the Dhanush. And then after that, the GSA program, again the mission in Dhanush and GSA, EGSA. So these are some of the interventions which Government of India has taken to ensure that we reach that this target. But still we know there is a problem. We are still not able to immunize completely. The challenges are there in the urban areas, especially the way they are expanding. So we have to, you know, look at our strategy, basically focusing on the urban area and strengthening the immunization program there. So looking at that, it becomes very important for us to explore what is the role that medical college can play and what is the support they can provide, whether in the planning, in implementation of the program, monitoring of the program. So this that. So looking at this, we are going to discuss this, and we have respected panelists there from different medical colleges, being faculty also, and the public health experts also. The ultimate outcome, what we are looking at is we need to know that if we need to envision the role of medical college, what is that that we can do, how we can loop in the medical colleges basically to ensure this support basically to improve the routine immunization coverage in India. So to begin with, my question will be to the Dr. Professor Nandi. Since you are the one who is, vice principal of the medical college, dealing with the, students, your vice principal of student affairs, I just want to know from you that that what do you think about the current load that medical colleges can play in the field of immunization, sir?
Right. Thank you for the opportunity. First of all, thank you for the honor. Giving in this August gathering, and I prepare a lot of academicians who is available here working in various medical colleges apart from other stakeholders in public health. And I believe that all the academicians who are attached to the medical college will also believe that one of the very important aspect about this is about capacity building that we talk about always. And the capacity building is about bringing out people, training them, and improving our human resources. As you said, that what can be done for the students? Yes, we can have a program, we can have something which is all which has to be incorporated in the curriculum itself when we talk about the UG programs. And when we teach the UG students about immunizations, maybe there should be some module for which the communication with the immunizations, which has to be done in the community when they go out and when they are done with early exposure in the community. And when they go out and communicate with, especially with the mothers, and impart that module to the mother, telling that the importance of immunization, not only for them but also for the kids, as a whole at large for the community. And that is for the UG. And we are also fortunate, you know, the stakeholder, the statutory body, MCI. That mandates that the CRRI, that the interns should have 2 months of 2 months of rotatory postings in our department after passing MBBS. So when they are posted in different PhDs, I believe they should also be given a project rather than not only looking into the patient in the OPDs of PHCs and taking part in the national health programs, but also maybe a project which can be given that they fulfill within these 2 months, how to cover the mothers and how to impart this education to the mother and bring out the result of that, that what do they believe about it, what is the feedback they got it from. That is about the UGs and the CRRIs. And next, I would also like to say about the postgraduate students. Our postgraduate students are assigned with families. They are assigned with various families and for which they follow up for the whole period of 3 years. When they are assigned with a family, they also have to look into this, and that has to go inside that they have to look into the immunization program, and they have to see that where is the resistance coming from. They have to say what does the community believe about it, and they have to see if there is any hesitancy in that, and then they have to come out with an ideas by giving their feedback to the department, and then it can be taken into the much higher level. And as I said in the beginning, for the capacity building, we being in a medical college, we can also be the trainers, not only for the students, not only for the postgraduate students, UGs and PGs, but also for the people who will be working in the grassroots level, I should say. That is the people who are actually involved in immunization, and the people who are actually monitoring that. And I would end it by saying that it is not only building the capacity by training them, but also we have to see that they do their duty dutifully with motivations. And for motivations comes something with dedication, and for dedication that comes with motivations, and all it brings down to the funding.
So thank you, sir. I think you're talking more about the how we can use the student, whether they are UG, PGs, basically in making their role in trainings and the community awareness. Madam Garg, I just want to know from you how we can, you know, how medical college can be helpful in basically in generating the regular update on demographic household. You know, we always facing a problem with the denominator. Being a so huge country, we are facing a problem with the denominator. Is there any role that medical college can play there? Any role that medical college play in the village health sanitation monitoring of those committees which are there? And any role that we can play more important on the VPD surveillance and AFI surveillance?
Thank you for this opportunity. But first, I'd like to give a quick comment on the previous Dr. Pratap Nandi is listening, because belonging to the Department of Community Medicine, the students come to us in undergraduate from first semester to seventh semester, and where they are allotted a family, which they follow it over a period of time. And immunization is one of the key components. That means they look at the family in a deeper perspective, and they look at who are the beneficiaries who are likely to be immunized. Then they're practically shown the cold chain, they're practically demonstrated the vaccines, and also, you know, during the internship, when they carry forward, they themselves practice the skills of it. So that's one thing. And then, you know, the second thing which you said, that we, community medicine is in unique position where we have our urban health centers, rural health centers, and also in some places, you know, the slum areas. Like for Delhi, we have the defined population. So already denominator is with us. So that's where, and also, you know, now with MCA, which talks of, you know, having PHCs, so denominator population is already there. So while, you know, collaborating for our own centers, we know that what is the immunization coverage, but even at the district level, the population is available where, you know, our postgraduates, they liaise with the, you know, district health authorities to have the denominator population. And also we put them into immunization evaluation coverage also, along with the state health authorities. So that is one thing. And there are certain important days like village health nutrition days or urban health nutrition days. So these are the key focal areas where we put them into, so that they come in direct contact with the communities, and they also learn how to interact with them. They know how to interact with the key you know, providers like ASHA, Anganwadi workers and all that, and they meet the ANMs over there. So they know who is the healthcare functionary, who's there. And then, you know, apart from not only coming in contact with the community regarding immunization, they interact with these beneficiaries also. And they improve not only their communication skills, but also the, you know, the healthcare providers' communication skills. And I've also been involved in, you know, adverse events following immunization. So we are also, you know, party to that. And we have involved our postgraduates, particularly in looking at that part. And first, we train them as to what are the adverse events, why do they happen, how do they happen. Recently, we also had immunization updates for all the medical colleges of Delhi, which I feel that we should be taking it further. You know, we should scale it up to all the medical colleges where we should know exactly where we are in terms of, you know, immunization coverage, then different newer vaccines which are coming up, the need for them. And, you know, with them comes the updating of knowledge regarding adverse events. So that's where we are, you know, updating their skills and how to handle this and how to prevent them.
That's the reason, ma'am, we are also looking at, you know, there are certain courses on vaccinology. Why can't a medical college take lead on that? And because we're looking at, you know, the today we have more than 12 antigens which we are giving in routine immunization. And we are introducing new vaccines. Very recently, we are going to replace now TT with TD, where the adult diphtheria will be given. So student will automatically learn, their interest will be towards the, when we talk about the vaccinology, their interest will be on, to understand the way vaccine work, what are the adverse events and all, and how do we do the surveillance part of that. Thank you very much, ma'am, for your inputs. I'll go to Dr. Sood now. You're having a very, you know, dual position. You are with the medical college also, and you are also handling a very crucial position as a state immunization officer. So, madam, just want to know how we can roll in medical colleges to create this immunization centers, you know, model immunization centers. If there, that medical college can be developed to create such kind of a model immunization centers. And obviously, this research work which medical colleges do, how we can involve them to do, I mean, research related to immunization.
I'd like to thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity to speak on such a big platform. I am a pediatrician and I work as a faculty in the Department of Pediatrics in Indira Gandhi Medical College, this medical college. And since 2013, I'm also holding the charge of state immunization officer. What I believe is medical colleges can have a very big role in running most of the national health programs. And since now we are focusing on the immunization program, so there is a big role which they can help in assisting the government in running the immunization program successfully. I'll start with the coverage. We do get reports, and the reported coverage of immunization, which is very different from what there is. I wanted to know the factual position, like whether we stand exactly at a 70% mark, which the Government of India survey tells us, or whether we are in a better position, what is as per our reported survey. And then we got the through their support, we actually came to know where we are standing. So this is a very important role which the medical colleges, especially the community medicine department, can help in assisting the state in getting these evaluated service done from time to time, so that we actually know where is the actual coverage of various antigens. The second thing which they can actually help is, like you told us, sir, ki new vaccines are introduced from time to time. So most of the time we are adding on the vaccine antigens. In Himachal, currently we are providing 11 type of antigens in our immunization program. So the communication to the field workers and to the our medical officers who are working in the field is actually done through the state, but definitely medical colleges can assist us in sharing the same information to the MBBS students, to the postgraduate students, because obviously they are the one who will be going in the fields, and then they should be knowing ki what is the schedule which is at par at present, because most of the time what as a faculty of pediatrics when I am taking send up exam, so the strange thing which actually happens is when you ask about the immunization schedule, so they are doing the same which is mentioned in a book which is usually 2 to 3 years old, and most of the time they don't know that the immunization program is not this, I mean the schedule is not the uniform, it's not that key, it's there in each and every state, so because vaccines are introduced in phases, so in this way they can also help us in orienting our graduates and our in postgraduates. We also need their help in improving the quality of the immunization through better supervision and monitoring, which they can actually do through the they can give some research work, some thesis, or the population which they are actually targeting in their urban and in their rural health post. So in this way we can get a better picture on what is there in the fields which is actually happening. So in this way, there is a great role of medical colleges, especially the Department of Pediatrics as well as Department of Community Medicine, in improving both the quality as well as the number, the quantity of the immunization program.
Thank you, ma'am. Yeah, that is what we are looking at, more of like integrating the program, and more important is to keep upgrading the knowledge, because in last 4 years we have introduced 4 new vaccines, and the there are certain vaccines which are nationally. There are still 4 antigens which we are giving sub-nationally. So they should know that number of vaccine which are being used currently.
And I think pediatricians and community medicine, this is high time, which has got to be a merrymaking.
Absolutely,
kind of,
absolutely.
We don't have to run in isolation.
Absolutely.
Because
so that
we
is
have
that,
a model
absolutely.
At different places, but we need to have an integrated model where community medicine and pediatrics, they come together on a common platform to run a model immunization clinic in a medical college center.
Absolutely, ma'am. That will be my next question to the panel. But before that, I just want to know from Dr. Soni, since you are looking after the coverage and equity portfolio, supporting Government of India. So what is your thinking that how we can roll in medical college, especially when we are doing the UIP reviews? It's very important when we are doing this reviews. When we are, when partners and other partners, like WHO and other government partners, they are doing the monitoring of the program. And there's a standard Government of India format for doing the monitoring. How we can loop in medical college to support this activity?
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the organization committee for giving the opportunity. I think the best thing what has been discussed here, that medical college students from the pediatrics and community medicine can play a vital role in planning and monitoring of the sessions. The RSCTs and the USTCs where they are placed, at least they can take up those areas, those wards, and they can plan their microrun, which can act as a pilot model for the areas. So that the district can follow how the meticulous planning can be done, how the denominators can be calculated, like some of the medical colleges are doing the denominators also, like madam has rightly said, in Delhi it is there, but it is not across the country. So definitely if it has been replicable in other parts of the country, it will be helpful for the program to get the 90% coverage. So that will help us to improve the activities. It should be uniform across the country. Basically, they can help in coverage evaluation surveys. That will act as an independent survey, because government always expects the independent surveys. And the surveys which are conducted on the national level are having gaps of 4 or 5 years. They don't have a uniform message. But the medical college can have the independent monitoring system, and that can be act as a tool for the state to guide how they can improve the immunization coverage in particular areas. So selected districts can be given to them. The nearby district in the medical college can have the districts in adjoining areas if they cannot go across the state. But at least they can adopt some of the nearby districts where they can go and have the monitoring system. Some of the states have adopted this also, that the medical colleges are involved in independent monitoring with the state. And state is owing their data, like WHO and UNICEF are sharing the data. Same thing can be applicable in other parts of there. Because WHO and UNICEF presence is not across the country uniformly. In high-risk states, there is a maximum places, the SMOs are there. But in other parts of the country, where the medical colleges are there, the private medical colleges are there, they can help us to give the independent monitoring data. So that will help us to plan our activities, where we have to focus, where we have to approach, and what things needs to be done in that area. So that will help us. Basically, the role of medical college will be important, because this is a teaching faculty. In the RSTC and USTC area, they can build the capacity of the frontline workers also. The training of the frontline workers can be taken by the medical college at that point, because they are the best trainers. They know each and every integrity of the system. So they can help in capacity building of those areas, adopting those areas, and they can just pilot the micro planning of those areas. So that will be helpful for us to cover how they can be involved in this. And that would also help their field experience. Like Madam has rightly said, they have hung the knowledge of the books, but what is there in the field, they are not aware of that. The practical hand-on experience will be there for them so that they can know what are the challenges the practically the ANMs are facing, the department are facing, and how they are resolving those issues with the limited resources. Because in the field, their resources are limited. They don't know how to go through the, in the books, the things are given as per the standards, but those standards cannot be practically applicable in the field. If they go in the field and learn how to do the practical solutions, they will definitely give some innovative ideas also. So some innovations, some piloting can also be done, some research can also be done, that will help the country to go ahead.
Absolutely. And moreover, they can be involved in special drives like Mission Indranosh, like when we are doing the MR campaigns. So there is the where this medical students, whether they are postgraduate, undergraduates, they can play a very crucial role in supporting that. But to understand that, it is very important for them to first get the training of that program. And I want to know from you, Madam Garg, that whether this field practicum scoring will help, whether it should be done or is the answer, or there is something else we can do.
I think this is very important thing which you said, that field practicum scoring has to be done. But otherwise also, you know, we need to look at what are the operational areas, you know, we need to look at. Because to my mind, it is not only kind of, you know, basic research or, you know, knowledge, attitude, practices, research we need to be giving to the students. It is the operational research we need to focus at.
Absolutely.
What are the gaps in the program and all that. And we need to do it in the form of a scoring, that means, and that will be very beneficial for our students as well. So I feel in this direction, operational research is going to be much more useful as compared to the routine research, like if we talk of barriers and challenges in immunization, what are there, what are the myths and misconceptions to this direction. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am. And Professor Nandi, I just want to understand from you what Dr. Garg was also talking about is the integration of different departments. It's not only the community medicine department, definitely they have an important role there because they are public, they are producing public health people. But other departments like pediatrics, any other department, what do you think that, what are other departments that can be looped in to this initiative?
Oh, yes, it's a very, very vital topic to discuss actually. Integration not only in this immunizations, now we are talking about integrations in medical education also, to break the silos, the departmental silos, and coming together and then teaching and then giving a higher level of education. For immunization, yes, of course, the concept that we deliver to our students in the form of immunization in the Department of Community Medicine. If it is integrated with the disease process and its prevention with the Department of Pediatrics, of course, that is going to give a higher concept of knowledge among the students. And I believe it is not only in the Department of Community Medicine and the pediatrics, some other departments also like medicines, OBGI, OBGY.
Absolutely, when we're talking about the pregnant females, that we are targeting 30 million annually. You know,
so it begins when the, it should begin, I believe, when adolescent become adult woman, a mother, that education should begin right from that moment. The importance of not only curing the disease, the importance of preventing the disease, basically those diseases which are vaccine preventable and we can easily acquire that. And this, I believe, by integration, we can definitely achieve this. And we also know, like, we come to know when the patient comes to a particular department, we know from which locality they are coming. We know what is belief and what is rituals and what is the mindset of that locality. We can understand how, what is that called, hesitancy nowadays. Initially it was called as resistance. those sort of informations can be actually gathered, discussed interdepartmentally, and then appropriate steps can be taken. So I believe that's a very, very important step to integrate to achieve this higher level of immunization coverage.
Right, sir. I just want to know from Madam Sood, from you, that you know, after involving medical college, looping in medical college, medical students and all, do we think of a kind of a giving a some appreciation certificates issued by the government or from the medical college that is going to help? I mean, what is your views on this?
Definitely, this is a very good idea, and because there are certain students who are ready to work as a volunteer, both in supervision, in research, in training, orientation of the workers, actually going to the fields, bringing back the bottleneck analysis, the gaps which are there, and assisting the state. So this thing can be done at the level of the government. So this can be put up, ki we can actually give some appreciation to them in the form of certificates, and in such conferences like this national conference, we can actually bring them on highlight, and we can request them, like, if they can share what is their experience, both going to the fields, getting to know what is actually happening in the fields. So this can be implemented, and this is really a good idea which can be materialized.
Madam, yeah,
ma'am. I think, you know, even for their further career progression, you see, as a medical teacher, I have observed that when it comes to, you know, after finishing their internship, a lot of them are looking forward towards the different careers, whether in pediatrics, community medicine, or they're willing to go abroad. You know, nowadays this is a trend which is more common. So they look forward towards what skills they have practiced. And to this direction, they need a certificate also. So if we have a practical logbook with different medical colleges, you know, when the student comes, like in Maulana Azad, we have got 250 students. It is difficult to remember. But right, if they come with a logbook, and we have practically said that you must, you know, work in the community, and these many children you must practically immunize, and you must participate in one immunization evaluation session or two immunize. So that gives us an objective way of assessing them and giving them, you know, certificates to that direction. And also, you know, then the student is conscious that I have to practice my skills. And the skills will vary at a UG level and a postgraduate level. So that's where we are looking at. From PG level, we will be involving them from a programmatic perspective.
Right.
So this we can incorporate in the certificate.
Absolutely. And I think inviting development partners also to you know, kind of some giving some lectures or yes, giving some awareness, this thing, awareness program. So I think that will be also very helpful, because a lot of development partners, they are especially working in very specific areas. Some of them are working in monitoring, some of them are working community awareness, some of them are working in new vaccine introduction. So we can call them as a guest lecturer, maybe to the medical college.
Yes.
Definitely will help them in increasing their knowledge. So with this, I think I want to open the house for audience. Please, sir.
Good evening, sir, and good evening to the audience. I am very happy that this topic has come up, and I like to announce that all these problems are addressed in one medical college, that is KVG Medical College, Sullia, and we have established dedicated vaccination clinic between OBG department and the pediatric department. That is why I felt very happy. Initially, only pediatrics, then OBG integration. Everything is required, everything is happening. And I am very happy with this team that is happening. Next is immunization schedule is, I have no questions, only sharing with what we are doing in our college. Combo card, one side, what national immunization schedule, district specific, state specific is there. Another side, what optional vaccines are, can be used in India. So these two are there. Government finds it difficult to put both of them because they are promoting, they cannot promote officially other things openly in the discussion, and we can have. But private sector can do that. but they have to maintain the quality. Next, the denominator problem. Denominator problem, in the college, we have got all those children who are born. But after the newborn vaccination and first dose, they go out of college, and that has to be tracked. And for tracking, we have developed a system. Last year, I will take one more minute. Last year, I shared a dedicated vaccination clinic with IAPSM, and that was considered as one of the best practices to be done in India. And this year, tomorrow, I am going to share that is extended immunogram. This is to support three PHCs that are attached to me. All of them have crossed 95% of vaccination coverage, including booster dose. Baseline, and it doesn't require more than 6 months. Because recently, I included one more PHC that was attached to us, Aranthodu PHC. Again, you know, same problems they were there. Whatever problem we have discussed, same problems were there. And these same problems are there all over India in all the medical, not medical colleges, all the planning units. They do not have the denominator. As a result, their coverage was less than 10% for the booster dose. That too in Dakshin Kannada, it cannot happen. Problem is with documentation. After perfect documentation, their coverage has gone up to 90%. All this we can do in 6 months, sir. So finally, we can do it.
Yes,
this
sir.
Is my message. And dedicated vaccination clinic is required in all medical colleges because these are the doctors of future. They should come out with the right practice. Denominator problem also, we have solved it. Integration of pediatric department and OBG department is also done. And we have supporting three PSCs. One more sentence last. After seeing this, our previous health secretary, Madan Gopal sir, he wanted one district to be made a model, that is Chikbalapur district, that we did a model in 2013 from June to December. In 6 months, we have covered that also. So what I want is support from partners and the government. If you support me, I can increase the vaccination coverage of any worst district in 6 months to cross 90%.
Absolutely. Thank you, sir. That is the reason even Dr. Sood is one who is a bridge between the medical college and the government. So probably, and when I'm talking about, sir, the denominator problem, basically, you know, the perfect due list which is prepared on them for the monthly immunization, the perfect due list is one which addresses four things. Between the two sessions, any death, any birth, any in-migration, any out-migration. If that is properly addressed, probably we know how much is our target for this session. So that is very important. And the catchment area for all medical colleges, basically the urban and the peri-urban, where the medical college is situated, is very, I mean, in that area, the migration is very high. Like we have studied in a city like in Mumbai, it's 25 to 30% migration happening. So that is something where we can seek help from the medical college to see that there is any mechanism which we can develop to track this issue. And obviously, if we know the denominator, then probably this kind of a situation where we are immunizing more than 100%, and when we go and see it, the target and the denominator is correct, then probably the coverage becomes down. So this is how we can probably help, the medical college can help the immunization program. You want to ask something, sir?
Sir, can I
Dr. Thakkar, and after that, sir, you.
Excuse me, sir. Sir? Yes, Prithu, sir?
Sir.
Here, in, among the panel.
Just a comment, right. Medical college have a very important role. See, this is the time when we discuss the next panel, vaccine hesitancy, we go beyond pediatrics and community medicine. You know, rightly said OBG, but also we involve, you know, medical college, it may not be present expertise in medical college, but they are in a right position to involve behavioral scientists, communication expert, social media expert, all these people, because you know, when we discuss, you, this is very important that the diagnosis of non-immunization or vaccine hesitancy or beyond is done at the district level by a group of experts. I don't see any platform in India where everyone who is working on immunization comes together. I am a pediatrician. I am coming first time to this conference. But I don't see any platform where all of us come together. This is high time that we, all of us, should come together and work together right from the national level to the district level if we really want to achieve the full immunization and sustain it. Now there is a danger that it may slip down. Thank you.
Absolutely. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir.
I just wanted to add one thing about that
migratory population you said. One thing which comes to my mind to solve that issue is continuous surveillance. And of course, that can be done by updation of family folders that we have under our jurisdictions. That in that way, medical college can be an important role. Updation of family folders.
Next thing is to add one more point without
taking much of time to Dr. Soni's point is like deputing people to monitor. I would say monitoring the monitors is also important. You know, the data that we are getting, whether it is actually the data for the papers or it is actually the fact, you know. So monitoring the monitors is also basically important. Otherwise, we will only keep on talking about denominators and numerators, and the fact will be something else.
Dr. Garg, you want to say something?
Sir, can I have one question, please? The problems which is practical problem faced by us.
Please.
I am Dr. Prashant Kokiwar from Hyderabad. So actually we have both urban health training centers and rural health training center. And we are having a very difficult time for cooperation from government. We are ready to work. We have tried to convince the government that we already have cold chain system well in place. But they are not ready to give any responsibility to us. We always go forward and get involved in all their programs. But when we ask for vaccination, they don't give us. Because we wanted their permission.
Right.
State immunization officer, district DIO's permission, and then only we wanted to start. Difficult challenge we are facing.
Right. We'll take your message, sir, and we'll make sure that, because we work very closely with Government of India, we'll make sure that message goes. But in certain area where we private medical colleges are involved, where the vaccine is supplied, like in Goa. Goa's 60% of the immunization happening through the private sector. So they have certain rule and regulations where, because some of the vaccines are very costly. We come to the PCV vaccine, which we are currently introducing in the system, is very costly, right? Private sector, it is about 4,000 they have to spend for one dose. So we'll do that. We'll take your message. Sir, you want to ask something?
No, I have no question. I have only one suggestion. I am Dr. Kulkarni, Professor in HOD of Community Medicine at KVG Medical College. Any medical college or any government official wants to establish a dedicated vaccination clinic, please visit our center so that you can understand the difficulties that we have faced and we have come all these things, and it will become very easy to establish an immunization clinic anywhere you want to do. And it will definitely ensure that whatever is the lower level of immunization, you can reach 90% within 6 months. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your suggestion, sir. Last question, sir.
Because teaching and the other academic is also very important.
the basic thing which can be done is the behavioral aspect, the counseling part and all those things become a routine part of the activities and the curriculum. Right now it is not a part of the curriculum. The students don't know how to counsel a mother, how to counsel a child's parents, or maybe who are accompanying them. So a doctor who becomes, a student who becomes a doctor, maybe he is left untrained on those aspects. So somehow we need to think in this direction also.
Okay, so we are discussing about how to train, students,
especially on the vaccine delivery system. So thank you very much. I'm just to wrap up this, I think there is utmost need to promote partnership between the institutions and medical colleges and district health system. And not only the community medicine department, but department like pediatrics and OBG, they also need to be involved. And medical college can really play a very crucial role in service delivery, whether it's a monitoring, research, or it's doing social mobilization work. It's very important. I think there's a crucial role that they can play there. And ultimately, I think it's basically a win-win situation for both. Coming up public health experts. For them, it will be a good opportunity also, and this will also help our program basically. And the problem that we are facing basically in the urban area, medical college can be a very crucial role. Because wherever they are situated, there are small urban areas and the peri-urban area which are not there in the sometime in the target, they are not in the plan. So helping and increasing the coverage there will be great for this program and definitely going to improve the UIP program in India. Thank you very much for your patience hearing and your participation. Thank you very much. And thank you very much, the panelists. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I request all the panelists and moderator to kindly stay over the dais. I request Dr. Nand Krishnan, Professor, AIIMS, New Delhi, Center for Community Medicine to kindly come over the stage to facilitate Dr. Preetu Dalaria. May I now request Dr. Preetu Dalaria to kindly felicitate the panelist, Dr. Sunila Garg. Professor Parth Nandi. Dr. Mangala Sood. And Dr. G.K. Soni.